Hello everyone, my name is Sofia Irisha binti Bajrul Iskandar and I am 12 years old. I am from SK Bandaran Cebu No. 3. Today, I would like to tell a story entitled Alibaba and 40 Thieves. Many years ago, in a small town in Persia, there lived two brothers named Kasim and Alibaba. Kasim married Vashti, a wealthy widow, and worked managing their inn, while Alibaba was wed to Fatima and was employed as a woodcutter. One afternoon in the forest, Alibaba was cutting wood to sell. As he swung his axe into the trunk of a tree, Ali recognized the sound of horses. Grabbing his axe, Ali quickly climbed up the tree and hid in its leafy foliage. Ali saw 40 men on horseback come into view and lift heavy saddlebags onto their shoulders. The group climbed below a tree that had a large crazy boulder at its base. Ali heard their leader utter a strange phrase, "Open sesame!" As soon as the men spoke, this boulder slid to the side to reveal a cave. Alibaba waited until the thief left the cave. In short time later, the men and their leader exited the cave. Alibaba heard the leader call out, "Close sesame!" and watched as the boulder slid back to mask the cave entrance. The men then mounted their horses and galloped away. Alibaba climbed down and stand in front of the hidden rock. Then Alibaba said, "Open sesame!" The boulder slid open. Inside, Ali looked around at the bags of gold and silver coins, sticks of fire-seek rocks, and chests of flour overflowing with colorful gems. They will notice a few missing bags of gold and jewels. Ali touched. He took some of the treasures home and he became rich. Soon, Kasim heard about it. He was very jealous. He visited Alibaba and said, "Where did you get all this?" Kasim kept asking and asking. Ali started telling Kasim about the hidden cave. Kasim interrupted him and said, "Take me there now." Ali spoke the magic words, "Open sesame!" and the door to the cave slid open. After a moment of shock, Kasim ran inside the cave. With a shake of his head, Ali headed home. Kasim filled his bags with loot. When he ready to leave, he paused and said, "Open barley," but nothing happened. Soon, the thief came back, and Kasim was killed by the angry thief. That same evening, Vashti came to Ali's house. "Is Kasim here?" "No," Ali answered. "I last saw him in the forest." So he set out for the forest to find Kasim and find out that Kasim was dead. Ali took Kasim's body back to his house. That evening, when the thief returned to their cave, they were curious how Kasim's body was missing. The leader exclaimed, "Now we can be certain that someone else knows about the cave." The next day, the thief, pretending to be the holy man, went to the marketplace asking the names of families who had suffered the loss of loved ones. Vashti was in mourning, but Morjana allowed the holy man inside the mansion to say prayer over Kasim's body. The thief recognized Kasim with excitement. His prayer seemed strange to Morjana, so after walking him back to the front door, she peered behind a curtain and watched as the thief drew a giant axe on the front door. Grabbing some shock, she ran outside and drew an axe on each of the houses on the street. That night, the thief who had posed as the holy man led the group to Kasim Street. Now, all the front door had an axe. The leader declared that he would have to find another way to identify the accomplice. The next day, the leader posed as an old merchant. He knocked on the door of Kasim's house. "May I see the master of the house?" the leader asked. Alibaba came to the door and said, "I am the brother of Kasim's. How can I help you?" "I an old merchant. May we stay here tonight and store our wares in your yards? Ali agreed. As Morgiana made dinner that night, her lantern went out. She went to the yard and turned the spigot of a barrel. No oil. Suddenly, she heard a cough from inside a barrel. Morgiana realized that the old merchant was a thief and the other thief were hiding inside the barrels. Morgiana silently glued the barrels closed. Then, Morgiana told the soldiers about the thief. As one group of soldiers set about arresting the robbers, Morgiana led the captain and his men to the mansions. The thief were tried and sent to faraway prisons. The moral values of this story is to never let greed take over your life. Thank you.